We are working in Module 3, and we're talking about character formatting in this module. We're all the way down to Section 6, where we're going to talk a little bit about working with numbers. You're going to have times when you have different lists that you'd like to number, and sometimes you want to number 1, 2, 3. Sometimes you'd like to number using the alphabet. There's different ways you can number. You'll also be able to number paragraphs. So let me show you a little bit about how numbering works. I'm here in a blank document, and what I'd like to do is go ahead and create a list so that I can number the list. I'll start with Alan, Bob, Carol, and Doug. Now I'm going to go ahead and select my list, and what I'd like to do is come up to the numbering button, which is under this paragraph grouping. You can see the numbering button right here, and I'll just click on it, and you'll see now that my list is numbered. If I click after the last name and I hit the Enter key, notice I get the next number in the list. And as long as I'm typing something next to it, then I'm going to keep getting the next number. Let's say I'm on number 7 here and I decide I don't want this number 7. I can do a couple of things. I can use the backspace key on my keyboard, or I can go up and turn off the numbering button. I did not have to create the list first. I could have actually turned on the numbers before I ever started, and then it would have worked the exact same way. I'm going to go ahead and select my list again. And by the way, when you select your list, you'll notice that it doesn't select the actual number on the left. That's okay. It knows whatever you do that it's going to affect the numbers and not the text next to it. There's going to be times when you want to number based on the alphabet. Maybe you want ABCs, or maybe you want Roman numerals, first, second. There's different ways you can format the numbers. You're going to find those formats back under your numbering button. There's an arrow to the right. First, you'll see a list of the recently used number formats at the top, so if you needed to access one of those again, you could. And then you'll see the numbering library. The first option in the numbering library is none. That's how you'd actually turn off the numbers. But notice here's some other choices I could choose. Here's my ABC if I want. Here's my Roman numerals. Let's say I go with ABC for now. And you can see now that they're numbered with the alphabet. Let me show you a couple of other options you've got with numbering. At the bottom of this list, just notice the change list level. We're actually going to look at that when we get over to Section 8, because that's where you work with the outlining. Let me go ahead and click on Define New Number Format. Here's the current number style you're using, and you can see a preview of it right here. If you want to choose another number style, you can choose from the drop-down list. And some of these are new. They were not under the library that you were looking at earlier. So here you can see 01, 02, first, second. Let's say you want to change your font. These are all of your font options. So you could have bold if you wanted, or if you wanted a larger size, or red numbers, for example. All those same options we looked at for fonts you can do with the actual numbers themselves. You'll notice when I click OK now, I have red letters over here, or numbers as you want to call them. Let me go back into Define New Number Format and just mention this alignment. Your options are left, center, or right. Notice if you have left chosen, that your numbering system is to the left of your actual text. If you choose center, it's still on the left, but it's in the center of that space. And then you've got the option to put it right. Another option that you have under the numbering is to set the numbering value. What if you have a list but you don't want to start with A? I can put any number that I like in there. Let's say I put J in there and click OK, and notice now my list starts with J. And that would be the same thing with numbers. If you put 10, it would start with 10. One more option under the set numbering value. Continue from previous list. Here's what this means. If I have a list already here, and then let's say I put a paragraph of information and start the list again underneath that paragraph, I can say continue from the previous list, and what it will do, instead of starting with O, it'll start with P way down here. So it'll continue from the previous list, however you had it numbered. Those are just some of your options you have with your numbering. I mentioned that you could also number paragraphs of information. So let me show you how that's going to work. I'm going to go ahead and flip over to my Burk Flyer and show you with that exercise. Back in Burk Flyer, we had several little topics here where we had a couple of different paragraphs, like this one here, buying a home. Remember that Word considers a paragraph anywhere there's a paragraph marker at the end. You've hit the Enter key. Let's say that I wanted to number these three right here. I would do it the exact same way. I would select them, go to my numbers, and now they're numbered. You can also number paragraphs. If you look down here at this one where it says we're growing, there's three paragraphs here. What if I selected those and turned on the numbers? Notice it didn't number this line number 2 and this line number 3, and that's because it's looking again for the Enter key or that paragraph marker at the end. So just know that you can number paragraphs as well. I'm going to turn that one off. That's how your numbering works. I want to go ahead and show you how bullets work as well because they're just like numbers except they're little pictures. So I'll join you over in section 7.
Hi, I'm Molly. Thanks for watching. If you would like to see similar videos, click the subscribe button on the right and check out our other Office 2016 tutorials below. I'll see you next week with new tutorials.